Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. This has to be one of the saddest news we've had to report since President Trump was elected. The American left has definitely become so unhinged, in a way that we haven't even seen since the days when George W. Bush was busy trying to rid our world of murderous dictators. As most of you are aware of by now, White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders was actually thrown out of a Virginia restaurant a few weeks because she works for President Trump. This makes her just the latest Trump official to be thrown out of a restaurant because of the mere fact of who they work for. And today she had a perfect announcement about all this harassment Trump officials have been going through. Trending, Melania arrives in Spain and stuns everyone with what she immediately did as she sat alone. Yup, it's about damn time everyone calms the hell down. On both sides. But especially the left, who all of a sudden, because of Congress members like the low-class Maxine Waters, who eggs them on and fans the flames, think it's okay to harass Trump officials only because they don't agree with them or because the mainstream liberal media told them they don't agree with them. Via USA Today, White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders was asked to leave a restaurant in Virginia Friday night by the business owner because of her connection to President Donald Trump, Sanders acknowledged Saturday on Twitter. Last night I was told by the owner of Red Hen in Lexington, VA to leave because I work for at POTUS and I politely left. Sanders tweeted, her actions say far more about her than about me. I always do my best to treat people, including those I disagree with, respectfully and will continue to do so. The restaurant's Facebook page was inundated with posts supporting Sanders and deriding the restaurant in Lexington, about a three-hour drive southwest of Washington, D.C. Calls to the restaurant were routed to a voicemail box that was full. It was the second night in recent days that a member of the Trump administration was hounded from a restaurant. On Tuesday, protesters heckled Department of Homeland Security Secretary Kirstjen Nielsen as she ate at an upscale Mexican restaurant in Washington. She, too, left the restaurant. The demonstrators jeered, end family separation, referring to the policy that Trump reversed on Wednesday. The policy had required that adults arrested trying to cross the U.S. border illegally be criminally prosecuted. If accompanied by children, those kids could not be incarcerated with the adults. Since the policy was enacted in May, border agents have separated about 2,300 children from their families. Sanders' father, former Arkansas Gov. Mike Huckabee, blasted the owners of Red Hen for their intolerance. Bigotry, Huckabee tweeted, on the menu at Red Hen restaurant in Lexington, VA. Or you can ask for hate plate. And appetizers are small plates for small minds. The brawl spilled onto Yelp, the ratings website. Some supporters of Sanders and Trump panned the restaurant, while their opponents backed the Red Hen and one complained of D**** H threats. Yelp stepped in and tried to referee. This business recently made waves in the news, which often means that people come to this page to post their views on the news, according to Yelp. While we don't take a stand one way or the other when it comes to these news events, we do work to remove both positive and negative posts that appear to be motivated more by the news coverage itself than the reviewer's personal consumer experience with the business. Trump's policy reversal has sent federal officials scrambling to accommodate families arrested at the border and held before their cases are heard by immigration officials. The Pentagon has identified bases near the border where as many as 20,000 people could be held. F.T. Bliss near El Paso, Texas, and the Mexican border has been identified as a likely venue for the temporary housing camps. All businesses should have a right to refuse service to anyone. No doubt about that. But not to harass their patrons. With that right, customers also have the right to boycott a business. And my estimation is this restaurant won't be having booming sales figures anytime soon. Even people who don't agree with the Donald Trump don't like this sort of bigotry against our president. And there was no reason whatsoever to kick out our press secretary. All that being said, the left believes they are doing people a favor by doing things like this. But all they are doing is cementing the fact that we picked the right man for the job in 2016 and that he will just coast into a 2020 landslide. After all, anyone who the mainstream media and the liberal elite hate so much means he's pretty good for us common folk. Don't you agree?